Well, here in my art studio, I like to paint mainly using oil paints. And oil paints are simply just powdered pigments which have been ground up very, very fine and mixed with a drying oil such as boiled linseed oil, which polymerizes whenever it's exposed to the oxygen in the air. And I'm using here a lovely vibrant red called Cadmium Vermilion. And there's also another substance used here in this apple picture is cadmium sulfide. And a lot of the yellows and the reds and the oranges used in oil paints are metal sulfides. And we're going to go into the laboratory later on and see how these are made. So here we are, as promised, in the laboratory, and we're going to synthesize some cadmium sulfide, which is that beautiful yellow substance that we saw in my art studio in one of the little jars. And simply what we've got here is a KIPPS apparatus. Now, you've seen this KIPPS apparatus before in one of my very early YouTube videos in the large laboratory, and it's exactly the same one. It's filled with iron sulfide, and then it's filled with a very strong solution of hydrochloric acid, and that generates hydrogen sulfide. And what we're simply going to do is pass through this delivery tube some hydrogen sulfide, which will bubble through some cadmium chloride solution, and that will precipitate cadmium sulfide. And unlike so many of the sulfides, cadmium sulfide is a very beautiful colour indeed, as opposed to the black substances that so many sulfides are. So we're in the fume hood here, of course, because hydrogen sulfide is an exceedingly toxic gas, and never take it for granted. So many people have been killed by hydrogen sulfide gas when they're mixing slurry tanks, and in Northern Ireland we have lost several families. In fact, one family lost five members trying to rescue somebody out of a slurry tank, and they were all instantly killed by hydrogen sulfide gas. It is nearly as toxic as cyanide in itself, but because of its obnoxious smell, we seem to put up with it. The problem is hydrogen sulfide destroys the nerves in your nose, and after a very short while, you will not be able to smell it, and then that's where it kills off your nerves. Also, we've got a very toxic substance here called cadmium chloride. All cadmium salts are very similar to mercury salts in that they're a cumulative poison, and they'll cause brain damage and liver damage. So it's always very, very important to label things correctly and to respect chemicals. Chemicals are safe if they're safely handled, but I see so many people on YouTube acting with great bravado and take unnecessary risks by handling very, very dangerous substances, when in fact you can have just as much fun with chemistry with a simple chemistry set, as opposed to always using highly toxic heavy metals. So, without further ado, we're going to bubble this hydrogen sulfide gas into this little flask, which contains the cadmium chloride. So let's see what happens. We do it nice and slowly. And almost immediately, we see the lovely clear liquid turning into a very beautiful yellow, sort of golden liquid. And what we're getting is very, very fine particles of cadmium sulfide, and what those will do, they will separate out and they'll be a very heavy precipitate. We can filter that, and believe it or not, I can actually mix that with linseed oil and make a pigment that will be used in oil painting. Again, it's something you don't want to be eating round or putting in your mouth whenever you're using it. So we'll just bubble a little bit more faster. There we are, we've got a brisk to overflow it and make a mess. We've just got these little filter papers behind it to help us see it. And very clearly, we can see there that we have a precipitate, which is beginning to settle down already, of cadmium sulfide. So we're just taking a piece of filter paper and putting it into a little Buchner funnel. Put on the water so that the vacuum pump starts. And use your wash flask just to settle it down. And then we're going to just pour our coagulated precipitate of cadmium sulfide in. And you'll see some of the sulfide begin to appear in the filter flask below, simply because the filter paper I'm using is low quality filter paper, so it doesn't clog up. But it will catch the majority of it. So we'll let that filter through. And as you can see now in the Buchner funnel itself, that lovely golden yellow precipitate of cadmium sulfide. So you can see our little steam oven is chuffing away there nicely and is hopefully drying out the cadmium sulfide inside. You can see that some of the precipitate is so fine that it filled into the filter flask there. So let's have a look inside our little oven. Yep, it's beginning to dry out nicely, and as you can see it's a slightly darker colour, it's gone more orange, and that's simply because cadmium sulfide is a thermochromic substance and will get darker the more it is heated up, and it will turn back then to this familiar yellow colour when it goes back down to room temperature. So we'll just let it finish off drying and then we'll begin to scrape it off and begin to use it in the art studio. So back in the art studio, we're going to take our very small amount of cadmium sulfide and we're going to mix it with an oil. Now, in oil painting you can use many types of oils. They all have different properties and different drying times. One of them, what I particularly like, is one from called poppy oil, and it's simply poppy seeds which have been crushed and the oil out of them. So I'm just going to add just a minuscule amount of the poppy oil to our cadmium sulfide. It's nice, runny, sticky, and whenever that's exposed to the air, that will then begin to dry. So we would normally use something like a glass pestle. So I'm just going to use this glass plate to combine it. And basically, if we were to thicken that up with some more cadmium sulfide, and I was able to put that, if I had enough of it to put into a tube, we would literally have some yellow oil paints. So I'm going to use that in just finishing off that oil painting of that apple. So you can see it's a beautiful yellow colour. Great coverage. Okay. And so we have made in the laboratory some cadmium sulfide, which then I've been able to mix with poppy oil and turn into perfectly legitimate, usable oil paints. And as you can see from the yellow here, very, very, very good coverage indeed. And I might start painting lemons with it instead. So I hope that was an interesting a chemical experiment that was able to show the practical uses of using sulfides in the art studio as well. So join me later on when we're going to look at some more yellow chemistry and the chemistry of sulfur. So please like and subscribe.